Airtable is currently in beta testing for their new AI feature. You may or may not have access to this already, but if you don't, it's coming very soon. What does that mean for your Airtable account? Well, if you want to get a sneak peek inside of this feature, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Airtable's at the forefront of our favorite no-code tools, and in this video, we're going to be breaking down their new upcoming AI feature, which is currently in beta. But before I start analyzing the good, the bad, the ins, the outs of this new feature, I first want to invite you to join me for a crash course. If you don't understand the key fundamental pieces of Airtable, you're not going to get everything that you could out of the software. I want to make sure that you're getting the maximum value from this amazing tool, so grab that free training at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I will include links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and go into the new AI feature. As you can see, I have a brand new base setup. Nothing fancy here, I just have review names and some notes. So the idea is that I've received some reviews, probably through a form or ticketing system, and I want to use AI to analyze these things so that I can do my work better and faster. Now, before I get to the actual building of the AI element, I first want to turn our attention over to pricing. So on the new Airtable plans, this is the plans that were released in September 2023, AI is an available add-on to the team and above plans. So if you're just on a free Airtable plan, you cannot add Airtable's AI on. But you'll notice when I hover over here, it says, harness the power of AI in your workflows. Airtable AI is currently in beta. After the beta period ends, it will be available as a paid add-on for team, business, and enterprise scale customers. So what does this mean? Well, if you want to leverage Airtable AI, you are going to be able to do it only if you are on a paid Airtable plan, team, and above. And what Airtable is indicating here is that it will be an add-on, an additional service, an additional charge on your Airtable bill every month based on this particular feature being turned on for you. Now, exactly what that looks like, we still don't know. In fact, I don't know that Airtable knows. I think they're still testing this and they're trying to figure out what the right way to offer this to others is without breaking the bank and breaking the business model. So understand that it will be an add-on cost when the beta period ends. In terms of what that cost exactly is, we have no idea. It could be variable, it could be fixed. We have no way of knowing yet exactly how it's going to be charged. So you'll have to stay tuned for future updates on this feature to understand how it's going to impact your wallet. But let's go ahead and flip back now into our little Airtable setup. And right here, I can start fiddling with the AI tool because it's been turned on in my account. AI in Airtable is actually a field type. So I'm going to come down here to the field type and just type in AI. And you can see that here it is, this new field called AI Assist. And if I hover over it like so, use AI to generate content, summarize key points, categorize information, and more, all based on your own data. Obviously, as I've already said, it's still in beta and they are reminding us of that right here as well. So when I make this selection, it's going to take me to the next part, which says, well, do you want to start with a template or do you want to start from scratch? If I go for a template, I get the nice outputs here where they've already tried to think of some different AI use cases for different teams. So product, marketing, UX research, and recruiting. If that's you, you can find them here. And also notice that I have the general selection here where I can do a translation from one language to another. I can do a meeting summary. I can do categorization of an object based on a set of predefined conditions or categories. There's a lot of thought that's already gone into baking out some scenarios that we might want to leverage AI for. In our use case though, I want to start from scratch so we can really take a look at the true back end of building an AI assist field. So what you're going to see here is that we have the ability to write the prompt that's going to associate with AI. And with that, we get the option to blend a combination of static and dynamic elements or data. Now, if this is the first time you've ever heard of these terms, Static elements within this context are going to be those things that are the same every time, whereas dynamic elements are going to change with every iteration of the AI prompt. So how do we actually get that to function? Well, as you can see here, we can add fields from our table. So any of the fields that already exist in our table, for us, we have name and notes here. We can reference those fields in our AI prompt. And of course, for every record, our entry, our input is going to be different for that field, right? Because this particular field is different from this particular one here on record or review two. So in this way, we're able to bring in dynamic data that changes every time the prompt is run. But we can also enter the static data, and we can just look at the example that Airtable set up for us to get an idea of this. You are a product manager with 10 years of experience in B2B, write a PRD for a new feature that matches the following description. And then in brackets, they bring in description. They're suggesting here that this is the field that they are bringing in from the table. And again, that's going to change every time the prompt iterates. And then we get a little bit more here. The PRD should help the business achieve the following outcomes. Here are the OKRs for that particular PRD. So you see how we're including a combination of static data, that is the prompt that is just text, it's not going to change, and then those dynamic elements, which are the fields that we're referencing in Airtable. So let's do that. Like for us, what I want to imagine is that we get these reviews and we want to just first categorize them. Are they positive, neutral, or negative? So I'm going to just write up a prompt to that effect. I want to categorize my review here. And then here, I'm going to bring in that review. Now to access the review, I can hit this plus, and here are the different fields that I have access to in my table. So I'll bring in notes because this is the field where I have that information. I want to categorize my review here. Notes. Please group this in either, or let's say, please group this in one of three categories based on the tone and information shared in the review. The categories are, and let's go one, let's go negative, two is neutral, and three will be positive. So let's see how this works. This is my first try actually putting this to work for us. Now you'll notice that down here, a new version of the preview is available. So we can click on generate preview and it's going to tell us what category it fits into, at least the one that it's looking at for this example. And I can also go over to settings before I get that far invested, and I can look at the model that we're choosing. So we have access to 3.5 and also 4. This is the more advanced model, 4, and it's slightly more costly. Again, we don't know what those costs are just yet. I'm sure we'll know soon enough. We also have a randomness factor here. If we hover over, you can adjust the randomness to control the amount of variation that users might see. I don't want any variation on something that I'm asking to categorize into one of three groups, so no randomness for this. And then we can also elect to generate automatically. Now, if I do switch over to GPT-4 as my model, I lose the option of generating automatically. I just want to point that out for you. If I'm on 3.5, I can toggle this on, and then it's going to just generate automatically based on whatever prompt conditions I've put out there. But for me, I actually want to keep this toggled off, and I'm going to create the field just like this. Once we've created the field, we see that we now have this new field here with buttons in each area, each of my different records, and I am given the opportunity to push the button to generate the output. So when I hit generate, what it's going to do is send that information to AI, and it's going to bring back a response. It's either negative, neutral, or positive. So this one I intentionally wrote to be pretty negative. The service I received was outrageous. I demand a refund. Okay, that's pretty negative. Here we go. It's been presented for us here, category one, negative. This one should be neutral, fingers crossed that AI agrees with me. Based on the tone and information shared, the categorization would be neutral. Okay, I could do without this text, but we'll get to that in just a minute. Now, lastly, the absolute best experience. Obviously, this is a very positive one. Let's go ahead and generate here, and hopefully we see that it comes back 3 positive. Perfect. All right, now why ChatGPT or AI felt the need to give me the preface here, I don't know. But one thing I want to point out about this field, after it's given us an output as it has here in this example, I can actually edit this text. So I can come in, this is now just like a regular text field. I can delete stuff, I can update it, whatever the case may be. You'll notice that it changes down here and it says, this has now been edited by you. You had something else going on here and you came in and made some changes. Whereas if I look at just the output that AI generated for me, it's gonna tell me that as well. This was generated by AI. But again, this is a text field, and that's what makes this field really unique in Airtable and kind of exciting, because we can send that prompt over to ChatGPT, get some sort of response back from AI, and then we can alter it, we can adjust it. This is really, really important if we're writing blogs, for example, with AI. Chances are it's not gonna get everything 100% the way we would want it. So it's great that we can go in and edit the AI output after the fact. Let me know in the comments below what you think of the new AI tool. I know we went fast and covered a lot here, so if you have questions, be sure to drop those below as well. And in the meantime, keep on building.